Your words were hidden way over in there.
Ten past six on the second.
Not a very nice day. Not good for us, not hot. Our neighbours there last night gave us a beautiful stew. Stag meat they shot the other day. Mashed spud with onions in it. Well, you mightn't be able to see Lex, but he's up there getting the beer, the one that, that's as far as I got to last night. Got rigor mortis, seems to be having a hoo of a job. Bit rigor mortis, is it?
I'll tell you what, these things don't get any lighter, eh? Hell. Oh, man. Oh, boy.
Well done. Well done.
Recording. Well, here we are. This is the morning of day two of the trip. Day one has been a tremendous day. We turned up in... at the station at late morning, only to find out that there were four other hunters had been in here since Sunday, so we're pretty gutted about that. And then to add to the disappointment, I guess, was the fact that the pick hunting club from Gisborne had been in here prior to lambing.
No, it wasn't from Gisborne, I believe it was from Hawke's Bay and all over.
Oh, it was a combined effort from a few clubs.
He didn't get Hawke's Bay or Gisborne in here, and a lot of the hunters are pissed off, I believe.
Well, the story was that that shoot was that they took out 78 pigs over two weekends out of the station we're shooting on. So the pig numbers have been badly knocked back. That's the Hungaroa River. Just waiting now for Bruce to up the track with the four-wheel drive and the first of the two deer. Going through these moguls here is pretty dangerous stuff. The track's washed down a lot of spots. Very hard to keep the accelerator.
Get up there!
the Hungaroa River again. Bruce Knight is recovering two of our three deer from last night's shooting efforts. In hindsight, we should have boned these jolly animals out. The saving you take with the whole body being brought out doesn't actually gain sufficient meat to warrant the effort. We spoke to some meat hunters last night and they were telling us about the actual weight of bone and skin.
The old fisherman once again carrying a deer. Fishing
in. How you going, Bruce?
Oh, a bit of BA. The shoulders, actually.
Could you please get that off your back, eh? Give us a bit of a story. What happened there yesterday, Bruce?
I blew ass. I carried it some of the way. Lex gave me a bit of a hand. We got to that tree and I couldn't handle it anymore. But fuck this. Lex looked at me and thought, yeah, I don't have to give a mouth to mouth. What will I do if he fucking collapses on me? Leave or stay. So he let me lay it down where it was. Well, that bloody close to our Jeep. We didn't know that all this flat was here.
Mark,
another boot. Hey, this thing looked pretty good.
Some landscaping here severely. Righto, here we are in the bush again. They're those things that we like best. Well, Lex likes best anyway. Don't worry, Joe, he's flicking over those real quick because he's making out he's not really interested in that part of the book.
He's comparing them all unfavourably, would you?
Here's Rod, he's already seen his first animal. Had a jam up in the bolt, was it, Rod?
Safety was on. Rod's life story.
Brendan, our new partner in crime. Give the camera away for Brendan.
Similar attributes to Larry Meredith with a cut.
It's a good excuse for a long smoke.
We always bring a good axeman with us, don't we?
That's the venison clothes. Pat, I hope it doesn't upset you too much.
Oh, God. And Pat's brought sleeping tablets this time. Can you fucking believe it? Sleeping pills.
Really?
You fucking soft top.
Yeah, he doesn't like my snoring, mate.
Jeez, that's a fucking bright head, isn't it? See that on the new study on bloody deer now, and they reckon they pick out orange, something terrible.
Venison stew. That's the animal that we shot last night.
I read in some magazine, they reckon orange is the worst colour to wear.
Wouldn't be in the.
It's the eye fillet steak from a hind and a stag. Would we call that thing a stag or a spiker?
The one we shot.
Yeah.
Spiker.
Well, that's the eye fillet steaks in there. That's what they're calling them.
Alright.
What are you doing? You're stewing it.
Well, yeah.
Fuck's sake.
This is the primo seat of the trip. A little bit like that later, I can tell you.
You can make a lot of
yeah, about 4 lux or something like that.
Walk over to the clearing.
Alright, we're on.
That was exactly 20 minutes from camp, I got that.
Yeah, and not difficult hunt, was it?
Yeah, you certainly had to use every skill possible. You know, I was looking around for sign, movement.
Went from the gamut of your skills, did you, from A to B?
Well, I had the wind swirling a bit, so I was moving around. Yeah. By, geez, a hard hunter, right, but...
Another hind?
Another hind, camp meat.
This fat kind of is the other ones we got, Lex, or? Not kind of...
It's funny, eh? It's easier to gut this one than the ones the other day. I don't know whether that eating bush tucker makes it easier to cut and gut it.
Yeah. Full of grass, eh, the other ones?
Experience.
Well, I mean, we felt gutted when we heard the shot. Probably the deer did too.
Well, bugger me, eh? Bugger me. Where would that be? Half an hour down the creek?
Get a bit more breeze down by the river.
So I'm going into the creek, am I?
What sort of gut shot was, this, Lex?
Aye.
How much meat's damage on this one?
Pat, here's a job for you, my man. This is a bit of you.
Pat's gone up to get the axe. Where'd you shoot this one, Lex?
I really feel bad when I do that. I'm in fact shot two deer there. That's the slinky. But the skins on those are absolutely superb.
Nowhere near getting born though.
No, quite a way off, huh? Oh,
you reckon? Those are still white, man.
Yeah, we've got so much bloody rat, but the models use the thinner stuff, eh?
Just sitting here pegging the right hunting time. Sort of doesn't pay to rush into these things too much.
No, I felt that I'd rushed. I do like that. That sweatshirt does turn me on, actually, Pat.
Oh. You grab a leg, Lex?
Oh, fuck. You want me to shoot it, you want me to carry it, and then you want me to really hang it up.
Do you have zero off on that tree?
Could you bring it down a bit, Rob?
No, I can't.
What's a bit of this branch?
It didn't look very stable, that branch he's using as his tee.
Open up that slot,
Lex. Oh, Jesus, great! I'm letting go! Hold it there, guys! What the fuck are you doing?
Looking for the old timer.
I think he did that to send me that.
I think so.
I fucking love it. I thrive on it. Right, lunch time.
What was in its bag?
I just have that knife, Rod.
Did you look in its bag? Food in its gut bag?
Yeah.
What was it?
This sort of stuff here.
Man, what a buzz. Pat just shot one. I just shot one. About five rounds out, it was running through the bush. I was just shooting at it like a madman. I got it. Right through the gut bag though. Never mind. Pat's just over that little gut over the other side there in the little creek. Here I am here, I just done the business. Didn't bring enough string with us though, unfortunately. Lex got one this morning, we heard another shot. Could have been Brendan. Who knows? Brilliant place. I'm going to try and tie the legs up. Probably going to use that bag, a bit of string I got. Heaps of string back at camp. Never mind. Pat, two shots, me about five. Never mind, one to kill it. Signing off. Well, here we are, Bushman Pat and I, deer each.
Happy as Larry. Hello, Larry.
Pat's one is very, very heavy. Quite fortunate in our case we had no slinkies inside them.
Slinkies being wee ones.
Tell us a story, Pat.
The unborn.
With the main highway here.
Lots of deer. We're very lucky to be able to shoot in a place with lots of deer, but it's about our turn. We've had famine for the last 5 years.
Tell us how it happened though here. Don't worry about that.
Walking up the creek, consensus to stay in the creeks. So we walked up a tributary, veered off into the central island of the main river in a tributary, and about 20 yards off the tributary we heard footsteps coming down the river, so I thought it was one of our other hunting buddies. Walked back to see what it was, and these fellas were walking down, so I shot one. One ran up a face, the other one ran away towards Bruce, which Bruce dropped, and we ended up with two. So that's good, because there's only two of us to carry, so we're happy.
Yeah.
Away?
We're away. There he is.
Five shot, 303. Done the job though. Gut bag shot, we're happy. Three animals in camp already, and it's only about 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
First day of hunting.
First whole day. Lex and I have got two back at Waimaha in the chiller. Let's hope Rod and Brendan's had a good day. Catch you up later.
Pat doing the big carry. I've left my knife back up there, hey, but it's another day. You know what a gut bag and whatever it is. Yeah! Had a good day yesterday. Four animals in camp. The first real day. Two back at Waimaha. Pat's one is a huge animal. And Lex's one. And my one. Brendan cut his one up, made into a backpack. Still pretty cold. Back stakes you can see hanging there. I'm very lucky with the weather. And saying that, I mean the temperature wise, keeping the meat good. Yeah. Pat and I are going to cross the stream. Up round through the bush, sidle. There's a side creek over there. I'm gonna drop down the side creek.
I know you're not gonna get sepo about it. God damn.
Touching marshmallows. Bruce, give us a few words just for the evening, eh?
Oh, fuck.
Okay, hang on. Yeah. I'm moving out, alright, thanks, Bruce. And Brandon, can you enlarge on that, or does that pretty much sum it up?
Yeah, no, it sums it up to that.
Okay, I'll move back to Bruce for just perhaps a conclusion to that.
Recap.
Yeah.
Thanks, Bruce. Now moving over to Rod. Now, Rod, do you still have LSD? No, sorry, it was a herpes.
NSU, herpes, syphilis, gonorrhea. Got rid of most of them.
And that deserves.
Yeah, okay. Oh, thanks for that. No, I'm panning around now. There's Bruce in the same position he was.
Does that come out on the camera?
There's Brandon.
Got some venison in camp. Did you zoom in on the venison over there?
God damn. Pat, what can you add to the
conversation? I'm going to go with the fuck as well.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. That's good. Thanks very much. I'll just pan back around. Well, that this will make a bloody good movie, this. The vocabulary is just
there's
awesome.
There's the hunting blues.
That's your rendition of 10 guitars or something.
Oh, fuck, I'm getting wet here.
A hula.
Go, Fox boys! at this. Takes a detail for crap. Here we are. Day three. And it is fair pouring down with rain. We're all wet, cold, and we have read the same story many times.
Here it goes.
We're going to burn.
Big new chair of spruces, which is extremely possessive of.
Smells good.
Rod Newbold, our intellectual team player.
I like it.
Brandon's girlfriend he's brought in.
Look at that. Lovely.
Yeah, half that.
Eh?
Oh, that's a big one, isn't it?
This one's saying, come on, Pat.
Have you got your meat?
Well done.
Lex.
Yes, Pat.
Get fucked. Stop eating that bloody licorice.
Do you want to try my cock desensitizer on it?
You want a bit of a rundown here, Bruce?
Well, I've only got about 2 minutes recording left.
Look, what we've got here anyway is basically four animals in all these bags here. We've had a bit of a clean up this trip. A bit of easy meat. First animal shop. 15 minutes from camp, the next two were shot 20 minutes from camp, the fourth one 25 minutes from camp. The company's been a bit different. If it wasn't from the south, it'd be a shocking trip. But, do you want to add a bit to the rod?
No.
No, what more can I say? Really, it's been
There's
a great
two
trip.
At Wamaha.
Here we are in the TeKei. Yeah, we shot three at Waimea, lost one, recovered two. Yeah, so tomorrow she's 10:30 out on the helicopter if this rain stops. But it's been pretty dismal with the rain. Cold, it's cold. Yeah.
Oh, that won't ricochet.
All that fucking log sitting to the right of that lump of moss in the middle there.
So what medicine packs down into.
I love that cow, look at that. Different sort of smell, isn't it?
Woo! Doesn't that look good?
Thank you.